I have the antenna hanging here in the center of the room here, and it's just being held up by a thin little piece of thread. And here you see I've got the coaxial cable attached. The center lead is going to the top part of the antenna, and the shield side is connected to the bottom of the antenna. And I've put extra tape on there to help reinforce the leads. You know, this RG58's got a real thin center lead, so this is kind of help support that. I've got the SWR analyzer over here on the table, and so I'm getting ready to see what this looks like on the meter. Again, I have no idea how this is going to turn out, and so I'm anxious to find out if this is resonant on any band at all. Okay, I'm going to start. I got it set on 4 to 10 megahertz. I'm going to start low and just start sweeping across each band and see if I can find a resonant spot. I mean, 8.8 to 1, 8.6 to 1, at 9.6 megahertz. Let's see, 10 to 27 megahertz. This is only supposed to go up to 27 megahertz. I'll come back to this in a moment. I see 7.9, 26. I see I'm coming down here a little, 18 megahertz, 3 to 1. Continue sweeping down the frequencies all the way down to 10 megahertz. So go up to 27 to 70 megahertz. So here's basically the CB band, 27 megahertz, 6.9, 7 to 1 SWR. So it's not usable on the CB band right now. 28 megahertz, same thing, high SWRs. I'm up past 33 megahertz. SWRs are going down. Oh, look at that. 1.6. That's about the lowest. 1.6 to 1 SWR. This close to 50 ohms, 1.6 at 35.927 megahertz. So 36, about 36 megahertz, it likes that. And I'll go all the way up to 70. Let's try 6 meters. 6 meters starts at 50 megahertz. And won't really work on 6 meters. . 70 to 114 megahertz. Okay, let's go up to 114 to 170 megahertz. Oh, I see a dip. Could be the meter since I'm close to 114, the limit.
No? About a 3-to-1 SWR at 120 megahertz. It's dipping again. Oh, look. 1.4? Where am I at here? 126.820 megahertz. 1.4 to 1 SWR at 126.77. So it likes 36 megahertz and 126 megahertz. And the 2 meter band? No, it doesn't like 2 meters. So, okay, now I've got a starting point. But that's kind of neat. 126 megahertz and at 36 megahertz. 1.5. And of course, once this antenna is taken outdoors, all of these SWR readings will change. Everything will be different, but this is just kind of a starting point for working with what I have here. So now I've got a few options to play with to try to tune this and make it into some sort of usable antenna. First thing, I could either, you know, the extra amount of wire that I have off the ends here, I'll just call them stingers. These can be made either longer or shorter, and so right now at 36 megahertz, of course, it's way too short to be a 10 or 11 meter antenna, and it is too long to be a 6 meter antenna, and so it might be possible to just shorten the leads and turn it into a 6 meter antenna. On the other hand, I could try to lengthen it, and we could do that by adding some extra wire and making like a capacitance hat and put that on each half of the dipole. Just maybe four, I don't know, about six, maybe say 4 to 6 radials, little rods that stick out here. I could mount them here, just adding capacitance, or I could put them at the very end, at the very top, and at the very bottom of the antenna, and that would actually lengthen the antenna. And in playing with this, I'm looking at it and thinking, okay, if I can keep this small, I can make it into some sort of indoor antenna. And so let's try some capacitance rods. Or a capacitance hat. And I'll see if I can figure out some way. I've got some small hose clamps. I don't know if it's enough for just clamping 5 pieces of wire together. And I only have over on the workbench there, I've got just one small scrap piece of aluminum ground wire that I was able to find, and it's only a couple of feet long, so I may end up having to use some copper wire to make some capacitance wires, radials, capacitance hat to go on this thing. So let me get started with that.